In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet, Secant-Tangent, and Tangent-Tangent Angles. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Our directions for this first section are to find the measure of the arc or angle indicated and assume that lines which appear to be tangent are tangent. So let's look at number one. In number one, we have this tangent line, FE, and we're looking for this arc F to G. Now notice that this tangent line is 180 degrees. So if we take 180 degrees and subtract 76 degrees, we'll get 104 degrees. So this angle is 104 degrees. Now you can see that that angle of 104 degrees forms an intercepted arc with our missing arc length FG. So 104 degrees is going to equal half the measurement of our missing arc length. Let's just call that X. So what I'll do, I'll multiply both sides by 2 in order to isolate my X, and I'll get that X is equal to 104 times 2, which is 208 degrees. So 208 degrees is our solution in number 1. In number 2, we have two separate tangent lines, UV and UT. Now remember, those tangent lines will intersect the circle, and that circle's radius at 90 degrees. So if I was to draw the radius going to endpoint T and the radius from the center point going to endpoint V, then we can see that those tangent lines will form a 90 degree angle. But not only have we formed the two 90 degree angles along with the radius, we also have a quadrilateral. And the angles within a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. So currently we're looking for this angle, let's say VST, and that angle VST is the central angle to the arc length that's missing. So if we take 360 degrees and we subtract angle U of 50 degrees plus our two 90 degree angles, we will get our missing angle. So it'll be 360 degrees minus 50 plus 90 times 2, or 50 plus 90 plus 90 will equal 360 minus 230 degrees. And 360 minus 230 equals 130 degrees. So this central angle is 130 degrees, and we know that that central angle is congruent to the measure of the arc, so the missing arc is also 130 degrees. So 130 degrees is the solution in number 2. In number 3, we're looking at an angle formed by a secant, QR, and our tangent line, RS. So angle SRQ will equal 1/2 the measure of that arc QR of 146 degrees. So if we take 1/2 and multiply that by 146, we'll get 73 degrees for the angle in number 3. In number 4, we have two tangent lines intersecting our circle. And remember, those tangent lines form a 90 degree angle with the radius. And when we draw in those lines that represent the radius, we'll form a quadrilateral. And because the arc length is 120 degrees, that central angle is also 120 degrees. The measures within a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. So 360 degrees will be our 90 degree angle plus our 90 degree angle plus our central angle plus the missing angle, RQP. So 360 degrees will equal 90 plus 90 plus 120, which is 300 degrees, plus the measure of angle RQP. So when we subtract 300 degrees from both sides, we'll get that our missing angle is 60 degrees, angle RQP. So 60 degrees is the solution in number 4. And number 5, we're looking at a tangent and a secant intersecting to form our missing angle. So that angle MLK will equal half the measure of arc LK, since that's the intercepted arc, which is 130 degrees. So 1/2 of 130 degrees, or 130 degrees, divided by 2, is 65 degrees. 65 degrees is our solution in number 5. In number 6, we're looking for the measure of arc PS. So because the intersection occurs outside the circle, we're going to take half the difference of arc PS minus arc QS. That would equal the angle. So this is a problem similar to the previous worksheet. So we'll have 44 degrees, and that will equal half the difference of arc SP minus 65 degrees, the other arc, arc QS. And if you want to extend that line out so that you can see where that intersection occurs, and it gives you a better visual for representing the arcs. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply both sides by 2 at the start. That will get rid of my 1 half on my right hand side, and 2 times 44 degrees is 88 degrees, and that's equal to arc SP, our missing arc, minus 65 degrees. So all I need to do is add 65 degrees to both sides to isolate the measure of arc SP. 88 degrees plus 65 degrees equals 153 degrees. So 153 degrees is my solution and number 6. And number 7, you can see that I have two tangent lines, JK and KL, that intersect my circle. So again, I'm going to draw my diagram so that I have a radius intersecting with J and with L at 90 degrees. Now remember, the measures of a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees. So if I take 360 degrees and subtract 110 degrees, because that's the measure of this arc, which is also the measure of the central angle, and 90 degrees plus 90 degrees, if I subtract it from 360, that will give me my missing angle K. 110 plus 90 plus 90 equals 290. So I'll have 360 degrees minus 290 degrees, which is 70 degrees. So 70 degrees is my missing angle in number 7. And lastly, in this video, number 8. However, before I go over the answer to number 8, please remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now, number 8, you can see that the intersection of the secant and tangent happen outside of the circle. Arc NK minus the measurement of arc MK. So half of that quantity will equal our missing angle L. So angle L equals half the difference of arc NK of 129 degrees minus arc MK of 61 degrees. 129 minus 61 equals 68 degrees. So when I take half of 68 degrees, I'll get that our missing angle is 34 degrees. So 34 degrees is my final solution in this video. Join me in the next video, where I'll finish this worksheet completing the second page. And if you didn't do so before number 8, like, subscribe, and share. And if you want to, leave a comment below.